Hello and welcome from Chile, Sofia. But no matter of the weather, it's Friday and it's time for our recap video. Today I'm going to start with a trade that I've posted last week. It's on the agricultural product corn. As you can see here from the graph, I've posted a trade with two scenarios. The first one was to go short from the action zone, and the second one obviously is to go long from the action zone. I prefer to play it on the long side. That's why I didn't manage to extract any money from this fall that the price made here. I wasn't sure that it's going to break this support level here, which was a previous resistance area, as you can see, a very strong one. And that's why I didn't play it on the short side. However, the price closes here, then it drops. I show it on the previous a recap video, and then it recovers and I enter into a long position here. The price started to rise, which was very good for me, but several days ago it made one drop, then it started to recover, as you can see here. But yesterday, by the end of the day, it started to drop and it hits my stop loss. Today it again opens here. Unfortunately, now it's rising and in my opinion there is a chance for the price to recover and to start going up and start reaching my targets, but the trade is already closed. I post a sign on Twitter. For those of you who are following there, they'll know it. For now, I'm probably not going to follow this product anymore and to look for another entry into the position. We'll see, of course, if there's something interesting, I'm going to make a quick video or I'll tweet a sign on Twitter. But for now, I'm leaving this trade because obviously it's not developing as I was expecting. So probably it's a good idea to leave it, and because otherwise I might lose even more money. The second trade that I want to discuss with you is the one from Monday. I've posted this one and I was very excited about it because, as you know, it's on the natural gas. During the past several months, we were able to extract a lot of money from this product on the long side. I've explained it into the video that most of our previous buy zones are now support level, and that's why I tried to implement the same approach. And as you can see, there was the place that I've entered. I tweeted a live sign on Twitter. The price started to rise, then made a small correction, and then it started to soar rapidly. It reaches our first target. I don't know if you can see it here, but I mark it as a profit taking area. I reduce 50% of my exposure on the price of 2.955. Then the price continues to rise. It makes several corrections here, and it was almost on the long-term target. However, after this, there was a huge drop. It drops to the log profit target. I've decided not to close the remaining exposure here, and now it's almost on the price that we've entered. That's why probably by the end of the day, I'll tweet a signal that we are moving the stop loss on break-even. So we're going to see how it's the price we're going to continue to perform, and if this happens, we're going to close the trade. We'll continue monitoring this trade because if the price is still on this support area here, which is our buy zone, we are going to play it one more time on the long side and to attempt to extract more money. But we'll see this in the future and to see how the price is going to perform. And the last trade that I wanted to discuss with you is on the metal palladium. I've posted this trade again this week because as some of you know, my colleague was having some days off, so the second trading plan for the week was mine as well. As you can see, I've made the plan. The buy zone is marked like here. Probably we are going to enter into a position in Monday, at least this is what the price is showing us now. The idea here was to wait until the price started to consolidate around the support level, but as I mentioned in my previous video, I'm going to be very careful because I don't want to be into the trade when the price makes something like this, even though after this the rise is very rapid. As you can see here, we had a long position and we are able to extract a very good profit from this trade. But nevertheless, I'm going to be very careful with this trade because I don't want to make the same mistake as the copper trade. I'm just going to quick show you what happens there. Some of you may know I posted last week. I was very confident that the price will rise from this support level. However, it drops, it hits my stop loss, and now it's consolidating here again. That's why I've moved, as you can see here, this was my previous buy zone. I move it around here, I'm continue monitoring this trade, and probably I'll see how the price is going to react in Monday. And if I see the appearing of a buying pressure, I'll try to enter into a long position and I'll make a quick video or just post a signal, because I already said that I'm continue monitoring this trade and I'm looking for another entry. And pretty much that was everything about the trades that I've posted in the last several weeks. Hopefully we're going to be able to extract even more profit on the upcoming week. We already did that on the natural gas trade, and hopefully it will bring us some more profit as well next week. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful for you. If you want to see more of these videos, you can follow us in our YouTube channel, or if you want to follow all of our other materials that we are posting, you can check our Facebook page or our Twitter page. The Twitter page I strongly recommend because the live signals are appearing there, and they're very useful if you want to just open a quick trade and to grab some free profit. Thank you very much for watching. I wish you a nice weekend and have fun. Bye bye.